Elmo visits the firehouse.
Up you go.
Oh, no, 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 Maria. Elmo would like Maria to sit first.
Oh, thank you.
Elmo will clean it out first. There you are.
That's very polite of you.
Thank you, Maria.
Oh, hey, guys. I didn't hear you come in.
Hi, Alan.
Hey, what can I get you?
Well, Elmo and Maria would like to see a menu, please.
A menu,
yes,
huh?
Yes, well, this is a very special occasion. Elmo is taking me to lunch.
No kidding.
Oh, yeah, Alan. Elmo's mommy and daddy goes out to lunch sometimes, and Elmo wanted to go out to have lunch with his special friend, Maria.
Oh, very good. All right, well, here's your menu, Elmo.
Oh, okay.
Okay, and what will you have, Maria?
Is that fried chicken I smell?
Mm-hmm. It's today's special. I'm frying some up in the kitchen as we speak.
Ooh. Well, then that's for me.
Okay.
Sounds good.
Elmo?
Oh, Elmo would have his usual, Alan. Yeah, a super scrumptious grilled cheese sandwich, a super scrumptious pickle, and a super scrumptious glass of milk, please.
You got it.
What's that?
It's a smoke alarm.
Alan, look!
Smoke!
Something's on fire in the kitchen.
I'll get the fire extinguisher.
I'll call the fire department. Come on, Elmo. Stay low and go.
Just a second, Elmo. Yes, I'd like to report a fire. My name is Maria Rodriguez. I'm calling from Sesame Street, and there's a fire in Hooper's store. Oh, somebody called it in already? I hear the sirens. Yeah, thank you. Come on, Elmo.
No, no, it was just me and my two friends. They're the ones that called you. Here they are. Are you folks okay?
Yes, we're fine, thank you.
All right, please, stand back, everybody.
Alan, what happened?
It was the grease in the fryer. It caught fire. I think I put it out with the fire extinguisher, but I'm not sure.
Fire in Hooper's store? Wow.
Scary.
You were lucky. Nothing caught fire except the grease.
That's a relief.
Yeah. Hey, and listen, I'm sorry. It looks like we bothered you for nothing.
Oh, you didn't bother us at all. This is our job. And you did the right thing. Anytime you think there's a fire, don't wait. Call the fire department right away.
We'll do that. Thanks.
And anytime you think there's a fire or smoke, you tell a grown-up. Okay?
Okay.
Is it safe to go back in?
Just as soon as we get our equipment cleared.
All right, thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Well, Elmo, I guess our special lunch turned out to be more special than we thought.
I think all three of us could use a special lunch. How about it?
Sounds good to me.
Come on, Elmo. One super scrumptious grilled cheese sandwich coming up.
Uh-huh. Elmo? Are you all right?
Elmo doesn't want to go back into Hooper's store.
Oh, hey, it's okay. It's okay. There's nothing to be afraid of. The chief said that the fire's out.
Elmo doesn't care, Alan. Elmo doesn't want to go back into Hooper's store ever again.
Elmo.
A fire can be a pretty scary thing. I guess a firefighter could be a pretty scary thing, too. Hi, my name's Bill.
Hey, I'm Alan.
Hi, Alan.
Hi, I'm Maria.
Hi, Maria. And who's this little guy?
This is Elmo.
Hello, Elmo.
Hello.
I'm sorry I scared you with all this stuff I'm wearing.
Yeah, it's quite an outfit.
And I need every piece of it when I'm fighting a fire. Would you like to know what each piece does?
Okay.
Right. Well, we use a lot of water when we're fighting a fire. So I wear this coat and these pants to keep me dry and to keep my body from getting burned. These boots do the same thing for my feet. This helmet protects my head in case something heavy falls on it. And this mask, well, sometimes in a fire, there's lots of smoke.
There was a lot of smoke at Hooper's store, remember?
Yeah.
And if I breathe in too much smoke, it can make me sick. So I carry my own air in this tank, and if I need it, I breathe it in through this mask. How do I look?
Okay.
So here's something I want you to remember, Elmo. If you're ever in a fire, go to the firefighters. They may look a little scary, but they're there to help you and take care of you, okay?
Okay.
Feeling better?
Elmo's okay.
Hey, you know, I just had a great idea. How would you like to come to the firehouse for a visit and see what a real firehouse looks like?
Wow! Oh, that would be terrific, wouldn't it, Elmo?
Well, what's a firehouse? Is it a house that's on fire?
No, it's a place where firefighters like me wait until it's time to go put out a fire. What do you say?
Well, could Maria come too?
Absolutely.
Okay, Mr. Bill.
That's great.
That is great.
Okay, that's terrific.
We really
want to
do this later.
We just go a little later, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
that'd okay.
be great.
All right, I'm going to clean up.
Okay.
Thank you so much. All right.
Well, here we are, Elmo, at the firehouse. Are you ready for your special visit?
Will Maria stay with Elmo the whole time Elmo's here?
Absolutely.
Okay, and Elmo's ready.
Hi, can I help you?
Yes, my name's Maria and this is Elmo.
Oh, you're Bill's friend. Uh-huh. She's expecting you. Hey, Bill!
Hi, guys. Thanks, Jeff.
Hi, Bill.
Hi, Maria. Hi, Elmo.
Hey, Mr. Bill.
I'm really glad you decided to come and visit.
Oh, Elmo's glad too, he thinks.
You ready to take a look around?
Sure.
Okay, I'll show you the different parts of the firehouse. We'll start with the places where we wait.
Wait for what, Mr. Bill?
Wait for a fire, remember? That's our job, Elmo, to help people like you when you need to have a fire put out.
Oh.
Okay, come on, let's go.
Okay.
See, we have a place where we exercise.
Oh, Elmo exercises. See Elmo's muscle?
Oh, yeah, good job. Look over here. Look, Elmo. In here, we have a place where we eat breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
Elmo helps set the table sometimes at his house.
That's good. And in there, we have a place where we cook.
Something smells good.
Yeah. It looks a little bit like Elmo's kitchen, Maria.
Oh.
Gee, some of the places in Mr. Bill's firehouse are a lot like the places in Elmo's house.
That's right. And then we have some places that are different, Elmo.
Maria, there's a pole in Mr. Bill's firehouse.
Yes, yeah, sort of like the pole you slide down at the playground, Elmo.
No.
Yep. And when the bell rings and we have to go put out a fire, this is the fastest way to get downstairs.
Huh.
You want to try it?
Maria has to come too.
Sure.
Let's go.
Oh, okay.
Here goes.
That's cool, Mr. Bill.
Okay, Elmo. Ready when you are.
Oh, now it's your turn, Maria.
If you don't mind, I think I'll take the stairs.
Okay. What does Elmo get to do next, Mr. Bill?
Come on, Elmo, I'll show you.
Oh, good.
Look familiar, Elmo?
Ooh, Elmo remembers that trap when Mr. Bill came to Sesame Street.
It's called the pumper, Elmo. Mm. Would you like to sit in it?
Sit in the fire truck like a firefighter?
Sure, come on.
Yeah.
That's great, Elmo.
We have lots of different kinds of trucks, Elmo. We use this pumper to pump water at a fire. Then we squirt the water at the fire with this hose.
Elmo was playing with his friend Telly in a wading pool once, and Telly sprayed Elmo with a garden hose.
Same idea. More water, bigger hoses.
Elmo squirted Telly back.
Yeah. What?
Elmo thinks it would be great to be a firefighter.
Well, then try this on.
Wow, Elmo!
Pretty cool, huh?
Yeah.
Ooh. Would Mr. Bill like to know a secret?
What?
Well, Elmo was scared before, but Elmo isn't scared anymore.
You were in a fire before, Elmo. That's a scary thing.
It is, Mr. Bill.
But as long as you know what to do, to call a grown-up if you see smoke or fire, to get out of a building where there is a fire and stay out until a grown-up tells you to go back in.
Yeah.
Well, then there's a lot less to be scared of, okay?
Okay.
Chow time.
Come on, let's eat.
Do you need a little help with that helmet, Elmo?
Elmo thinks Mr. Bill's helmet might be a little heavy.
You want me to take it off?
No, it's okay. It's okay.
It's really nice of you to do this.
No, it's our pleasure. Thanks, Mookie. Here you go, Elmo. A grilled cheese sandwich, a pickle, and a glass of milk.
Look, Maria. It's the super scrumptious lunch that Elmo didn't get to have at Hooper's store.
Oh, you're so lucky.
Yeah. Oh, thank you, Mr. Bill.
You're welcome, Elmo.
Thank you, firefighters.
Yeah.
Yay for the firefighters.
Come on, everyone. Let's eat.
Oh,
yeah.
Well, it sounds like the trip to the firehouse was a big success.
Oh, the firefighters were really great. They could tell that Elmo was still really upset about the fire, and they knew exactly what to do to make him feel better.
To make him feel a whole lot better, I'd say.
Oh. Ring up the pumper, firefighters! We need to squirt more water on the fire! Vroom, 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 vroom. Squirt, 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 squirt!
I think to become a firefighter, you have to be brave, be pure-hearted, and care about other people.
When I grow up, I want to be a girl firefighter.
Ding, ding, ding!
Fire dogs are really excellent, and they're so great because they are so excellent.
I like firefighters because they save people.
Thank you, firefighters!
Thank you, firefighters!
Thank you, firefighters. I love you.
Hi, this is Elmo's friend Susan, and guess what? She's a firefighter!
Hi!
Oh, Susan is going to show us what to do if there's a fire. Elmo was just in the Hooper store when there was a fire.
Yes, you were, Elmo. Yeah. And what did you do?
Oh, well, Elmo had to get low and go like this. Just like that.
That's right, Elmo. That's what you do if there's a fire. Mm-hmm. You get low and go and stay outside until a firefighter tells you it's safe to go back inside.
Yeah. Get low and go and get outside and stay outside like this.
Elmo?
Is it safe to come back?
It's safe.
Oh, good. Thank you, Susan.
You're welcome, Elmo.
If there's a fire in your house or any place you've just been, get out, stay out, don't you go back in.
Don't you go back in.
If there's a fire anywhere, there's danger there. Get out, stay out, don't you go back in.
Don't you go back in.
And once you get outside, that is where you should stay. Till a grown-up says that it's okay.
It's okay.
There's no two ways about it, so let me hear you shout it. Get out, stay out, don't you go back in.
Get out, stay out, don't you go back in.
If you left your teddy bear on your favorite chair, get out, stay out, don't you go back in.
Don't you go back in.
And if you lost one shoe or your toy kangaroo, get out, stay out, don't you go back in.
Don't you go back in.
And if you left your truck or your favorite doll, or your rubber duck or your basketball, there's no two ways about it, so let me hear you shout it. Get out, stay out, don't you go back in.
Get out, stay out, don't you go back in.
Hey, I'm talking serious here now.
Mm-hmm. Whoop,
Hi there, everybody. Hey, I bet you're wondering, what is Ernie hiding behind his back? Well, I'll give you a clue. It's small and yellow. No, I said small and yellow. Nope, it's not a banana. Here's another clue. It's small and yellow and you squeeze it. Nope, it's not a lemon. But that's a good guess. It's small, it's cute, it's yellow, and it puts out fires. That's right, folks. It's Fire Chief Rubber Ducky, the brave and daring firefighter. Oh, Fire Chief Rubber Ducky, you are a credit to your community. Mm-hmm. I guess you get your water from the tubby, huh?
Let's draw a firefighter, and I'll need your help. What does a firefighter wear?
He wears a suit.
No, not a jacket, not a work suit.
He wears a fire suit.
Yeah, that's it.
They wear a uniform
to protect them from the heat.
He wears a hat on his head, too.
No, not a feathers, not a pirate's
that's
hat.
That's silly.
Yeah!
What else does a firefighter need?
Water!
No!
A hose!
Water from a hose.
And what does a firefighter fight? A dragon?
No!
Not a dragon. They fight fires.
Fire!
Like that? Thanks for the drink.
Oh, I'm just doing my job.
Hooray!
My dad's a real firefighter.
My dad's a super daddy. Now, what do you think of that? He plays with me and my brother. He gave me a fireman's hat. Lights and tires, just like the one my daddy rides when he goes to put out fires. And someday I'd be glad, so very, very glad, if I could be a firefighter just like my super dad. His fire truck is shiny red, he wears his special boots. The firefighters all get dressed in firefighting suits. And when the fire bell goes off, let's go, they always shout. They jump onto the fire truck and put that fire out. Glad, so very, very glad, if I could be a firefighter just like my super dad. He's cool.
Too. Look. firefighters wear to keep safe when they put out fires? Oh, that's a very good question, Dorothy. Oh, maybe we should ask Mr. Noodle. Mr. Noodle! Shade sounds just like a fire engine. Very good, Shade. Now go up, please. Thank you, Shade. Oh, look! It's Mr. Noodle's sister, Miss Noodle. Hi, Miss Noodle. Hi. Oh, Miss Noodle. Wow. Miss Noodle is really good at spinning. Oh. Boy, but she sure needs to work on stopping. Miss Noodle. Miss Noodle. Are you there? Oh. There you are. Hi, Miss Noodle. Boy, what do firefighters wear to keep safe when they put out fires? Oh, she knows. Miss Noodle.
No, that's not right.
Hey, that's a football uniform.
That's for football, not for fighting fires.
Yeah, that's what football players wear, Miss Noodle.
You can't fight a fire in that. That's what football players wear to keep safe.
And it really works.
Try again, Miss Noodle.
What do firefighters wear to keep safe?
No!
That's a suit of armor. You can't fight a fire in that. That's what knights wear to keep safe.
What do firefighters wear?
No, they don't wear armor. No.
Try again, Miss Noodle.
You can do it.
Try again.
Whoa.
Careful, Miss Noodle.
Yay!
Yeah, that's right.
That's a firefighter's uniform. Miss Noodle is pretending to put out a fire.
What's wrong, Miss Noodle?
But there's no water coming out.
No water?
Oh.
Where's the water?
Where's the water? Boy, those noodles are very good at getting wet. Yeah, Dorothy? Okay. Dorothy wants to ask someone else. What do firefighters wear to keep safe when they put out fires?
Dorothy, see these gloves? Firefighters wear them so their hands don't get burnt.
Hey, Dorothy, see this coat? This coat protects firefighters from getting wet or getting burnt. Yeah, it does feel kind of heavy. It's about 5 pounds.
Hi, Dorothy. Firefighters wear these boots when they put out fires to keep their feet from getting wet or burned.
Thank you, everybody. Oh, and thanks, Dorothy. Now, Elmo will ask our baby. Oh, hello, baby. Baby, what do firefighters wear to keep safe when they put out fires? Oh, yeah, a helmet to keep their heads from getting hurt. Oh, thank you, baby. And now...
coming through.
Oh, they must be going to put out a fire. Now, where was Elmo? Oh, yeah. And now, Elmo has a question for you. How many firefighters are in this fire truck? Let's count them and see. Fire truck!
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
12 firefighters in a fire truck! Oh, boy. And one big elephant hose. Oh, great counting, everybody. And now...
Elmo has mail! Elmo has mail!
Slow down, computer! Where's the fire?
Elmo has mail!
Hey, Elmo has mail!
Elmo has mail!
Computer, where are you? Elmo has mail! Stop!
Elmo has mail!
At last, Elmo can get his email. Oh boy, Elmo got email from his friend Oscar.
Hey, Elmo. Since I don't help whenever I can, this email is not about firefighters. It's about the toast I'm making. It's gonna be just the way I like it. Burnt! Yum!
Trash can on fire!
Stand back, please, sir.
Okay, we got a hot trash can here.
Hey.
Oh, don't touch the can, please, sir. You might get burned.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Turn on the water.
Get the water.
Turn on the water. Okay, the fire's out.
Okay, it's safe now, sir.
Yeah.
You can return to your trash can. Mm-hmm.
What's the big idea?
Have a nice day.
You ruined my bird toast. Now it's all wet and soggy. Wet and soggy bird toast? Mmm, delicious. And that's my email about bird toast, Elmo. Hey, wait a minute. It was about firefighters too, wasn't it? Oh, phooey.
Thanks for the email, computer.
Wow. Hot trash cans can burn you. Let's find out what else can burn you. Oh, drawer. There you are. Drawer's not hot. It won't burn down, Mo. Okay, drawer, open up. No, open up, drawer. No. Stay. Don't come with Elmo. Just open up, please. Oh, boy. Drawer's supposed to open. Can birthday cakes burn you?
No. But the candles on the birthday cake can.
Blow them out quick. Very good. Can stoves burn you?
Yes. Don't touch stoves.
Can bowls burn you?
No.
Unless there's hot porridge in them.
Don't touch it, baby bear.
Come on, porridge, get cool.
I'll help. I'll huff and I'll puff.
Not me! Not me, the porridge!
Ooh, porridge!
Elmo's friend Sabrina knows that fire can burn you. That's why she practices what to do in case there's a fire in her house. And Sabrina told Elmo all about it. Oh, you want to watch too, Drew? Okay. Go ahead, Sabrina.
Lots of times my mom, dad, and I have a fire drill. That's when we practice getting out of our apartment, the way we would in a real fire. My mom makes sure I know where we can meet. First, I get low and go. You're supposed to do that, because if there's a fire, there's smoke, and you have to get below the smoke. I meet my mom where we said we'd meet. I'm happy to see her. My mom touches the door to make sure it's not hot, and there is no fire outside the door. I know the safe ways out of my apartment. My dad is practicing using the fire escape. We know where to meet him outside. My mom and I go down the hallway and walk down the stairs. We still have to stay low. Then we go outside. When we get outside, we meet my dad at the corner. That's our safe place to meet. In a real fire, we would stay out until the firefighters tell us when to go back inside. But this isn't a real fire, so we can go back inside now. I'm glad we have fire drills. Now I know what to do in case of a real fire. And I feel a lot safer.
Aw, thanks, Sabrina. Oh, that gives Elmo an idea. Elmo's gonna practice how to get low and go. You wanna practice with Elmo? Oh, good. Okay, let's get low. Are you low? Okay, now let's go. Hey, come back. There you are.
But now, Elmo wants to learn more about firefighters, don't you? How can we find out more? Oh, look! The TV is practicing how to get low. Oh, and go! Wait! Come back! Come back, TV! Elmo wants to see the firefighter channel. Good, now turn yourself on.
The Firefighters Channel. All firefighters all the time. The channel that's really hot. Today, Mike, the firefighting dog.
One day, Mike, the firefighting dog, was eating his dinner in his firehouse when all of a sudden, the fire alarm sounded. That meant there was a fire to fight. Mike slid down the fire pole and in a jiffy put on his special firefighting clothes to protect him from the fire. And his helmet to keep his head from getting hurt. Then he rushed to the fire. When he got to the fire, he heard barking coming from inside the house. So Mike put on his air tank and mask to keep from breathing in smoke and went into the burning house. He pulled a young pup from the flames and then put out the fire. It was all in a day's work for Mike, the firefighting dog. The end. Or is it?
Look, Mikey's dreaming again.
Dreaming about chasing cats, Mikey?
Time to go fight a fire.
Watch the firehouse for us, Mikey.
Now it's the end.
Coming up next on the Firefighters Channel, The Flaming of the Shrew, starring Carol Burnett.
Want to talk to a firefighter?
Oh, boy! Elmo can talk to his friend, Firefighter Richard! Yay!
Don't forget us!
Oh, yeah! Elmo can talk to everybody!
So what do you want to know, Elmo?
Well, Elmo thinks fires are scary.
They are scary.
Oh yeah, very scary.
Well, is it scary being a firefighter?
Sure.
Oh yeah, sure. Very scary.
But I take care of myself, so it's okay. I wear these special clothes that help keep me safe.
Oh yeah, special clothes.
Oh, Elmo knows all about the boots and the coat and the helmet.
And I'm part of a team of firefighters. We work together and help keep each other safe.
Oh, a team. Oh, like a soccer team?
Yeah, sort of.
Oh yeah, we're a team. We're buddies. Hi, buddy.
Hi.
Oh, look. Dorothy's imagining Elmo as a firefighter.
Oh yeah, a firefighter.
Elmo is ready to fight a fire.
Firefighters don't only fight fires.
Really?
We also help animals.
Meow. Oh, a kitty needs help. Firefighter Elmo is on the way. Meow. Hello, kitty. Meow. Here, kitty. You're safe now, kitty. Take us down, Justin! Whee!
Firefighters help people who get hurt, too.
Firefighter Elmo will help. Much better. Thanks, Firefighter Elmo. Just doing Firefighter Elmo's job. Firefighter Richard must really like being a firefighter.
I wouldn't want to do anything else.
Oh yeah, nothing else.
Well, I better get going. It's time for me to go home and cook dinner for my kids.
Firefighter Richard is a daddy, too? Wow, firefighters are amazing.
Oh yeah, amazing.
I'll see you later.
Oh. Bye-bye, buddy.
Bye, Firefighter Richard. Thanks. Elmo really loves firefighters. So does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the firefighter song. Yay!
Yay!
Firefighters, firefighters.
Firefighters! Firefighters, firefighters, firefighters! Firefighters, firefighters, firefighters!
Say goodbye, Dorothy! Say goodbye, firefighters!
Oh, yeah!
Oh, yeah!
Goodbye!
You too, fire truck!
See ya!
Yep, there he is, my great buddy, Hero Guy. And look, a wee little kitten up in a tree. Hey, Hero Guy, what's doing?
What's doing? You drew a picture of a kitten up in a tree.
Yeah, so?
So, now it wants to come down from the tree and doesn't know how.
Well, so help her down.
But you drew it. You're the artist.
But you're the superhero.
Good point. So let me get back into the picture and solve this problem with the kitty.
As well you should, Mr. Superhero Guy. Oh, the poor little kitty does want to come down.
That's right. And I, Hero Guy, just thought of a super way to solve this problem. I will fly to the top of the tree and carry the kitty down myself. Watch! Come on, kitty! Ew, little kitty, kitty, kitty!
Meow, meow, meow.
She doesn't seem to want to go with me. What's the matter?
I don't know. I guess she's not used to seeing people, you know, like, fly around trees. I think flying around like that scares her.
Oh, but I'm a hero. I'm supposed to save her, not scare her.
That's true.
I will not give up. I will find a super way to get this kitty out of the tree right now. I know. I will turn myself into a trampoline. Watch this. Ta-da!
Good work, Hero Guy! Okay, kitty. Okay, now come on. Come on, jump onto the trampoline. It's very bouncy. Yeah, and you'll be able to bounce on it, and then you'll come down.
Meow!
I think she bounced a little too hard.
As a hero guy, I have failed. I tried to get the kitty out of the tree, but I couldn't do it.
No. Come on, hero guy. I drew you, so I know you can do it. You know, you can't always solve a problem right away, you know? Sometimes it takes time, you know, to find the right strategy, you know? The right steps, yeah, to solve the problem.
Steps? Steps? That's it! Ta-da!
Brilliant thinking, hero guy! I knew you could do it! Come on, little kitten. Come on, walk down those heroic steps! You did it!
Give me paw!
And so ends another brave, yet true, adventure with Hero Guy. What a hero! What a guy!
These great products from Sesame Street.
Who doesn't have a favorite song?
Everybody does.
If you love kids' favorite songs, then you'll want to join Elmo and his Sesame Street friends for Kids' Favorite Songs, too. Pick your favorite from 15 songs, all guaranteed to get you dancing.
The wheels on the bus go round and round.
Rubber ducky, you're the one.
Plus, there's an extra special bonus, the Sesame Street feature hero guy.
I didn't expect to see that.
Kids' Favorite Songs, too. Coming this October on video, CD, and cassette. Only from Sesame Street and Sony Wonder.
I love it! Elmo's a cowboy in the Wild Wild West! Yay!
Elmo's World Wild Wild West, an all-new home video special. Hop on your pony and join Elmo and his partners on a Wild West adventure.
He put the wild in Wild Wild West. Was the ridin'est, ropin'est cowboy.
She'll be coming round the mountain when she comes. She'll be coming round the mountain. She'll be coming around the mountain.
A video your kids will enjoy till the cows come home.
What's cooking on Sesame Street?
Oh, one of Elmo's favorites.
Sample an all-new musical adventure with Elmo's Magic Cookbook, now on video. It's a festive feast featuring everyone's favorite furry red friend.
Are you pulling Elmo's leg?
Join Elmo and his Sesame Street friends for an enchanting mix of whimsical songs and fun food battles. That also includes a visit with Super Chef Emeril Lagasse.
We can kick it up a notch.
For a taste of something special, don't miss Elmo's Magic Cookbook. Brand new on VHS, only from Sony Wonder.
Bon appetit!
It's musical. It's magical. It's Elmo.
This is gonna be fun.
Elmo's Musical Adventure. The story of Peter and the Wolf on VHS and DVD.
What's your favorite song?
Bob, Bob, Black Sheep is my favorite song. Next to Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star in the Alphabet song. What am I gonna do?
You don't need to choose with Kids' Favorite Songs, new on home video from Sesame Street and Sony Wonder. It's a countdown of 9 all-time favorites that's sure to hit a high note with everyone in your family.
Row, row, row your boat.
I've been working on the railroad.
Take 15 sing-along treats with you wherever you go with Kids' Favorite Songs on CD and cassette.
I've got it! I know what my favorite song is!
With the best love tunes on Kids' Favorite Songs, you'll always have something to sing about.
Only from Sony Wonder.
wherever children's videos, CDs, cassettes, and book and tape sets are sold.